speak.
我主耶稣基督圣名我讲话。
Peace to everyone.
祝大家平安。
According to the arrangement of the church, today we are going to study Esther chapter 8.
根据教会的进度呢，我们今天安排查耶记第八章。
I think the story of is about salvation to the Jewish nation.
那以斯帖的故事呢，是有关犹大人被救赎的一个经历。
The book talks about two main characters, Esther and Mordecai.
那这本书呢，提到了两个人物，一个是以斯帖，一个是莫迪改。
These two individuals are related. So Mordecai was the uncle to Esther.
那在这里呢，这两位主人公呢是互相有关系的亲属。莫迪改呢是以斯帖的舅舅叔叔。
So in the book, we are told that Haman plotted to destroy the entire nation of Israel.
那这本书里面呢提到，哈曼呢想把整个犹大民族灭掉。
We know that in the time of Russian Empire, you know, a king was not supposed to change his own decree.
那在我们知道历史上呢，在波斯帝国的时候呢，那个帝王呢是不能够随意去改他的谕旨的。
So what has been issued, you know, by the king himself cannot be changed later on.
所以呢，这个波斯帝王他自己下的这个谕旨呢。 已经下来的谕旨呢，是在后面是不能更改。So
the king actually agreed, you know, to destroy the entire nation.
所以呢，之前呢，这个王帝呢已经同意把整个犹大民族灭了。
So for them to, you know, for Esther and Mordecai, you know, to turn the situation around is indeed a great miracle in itself.
所以呢，以斯帖和莫迪改最后能够把这个结果呢完全的。 更改过来呢，是一个很大的奇迹。
We mentioned when we were the chronicle that has been chosen was about how Mordecai has saved the king early on.
那很神奇的呢，就是这个被选出来读的历史章节呢，是讲的是怎么救了王的事情。
That is in chapter 2 from verse 19 onwards.
那是记载在第二章里面的19节以下。
You find that, you know, when this incident initially made known, was made known to the king, the king actually knew about it, and this incident was recorded in Chronicle for the king.
那这件事情呢，就是说，很神奇的，就是王其实是知道这件事情的，可是也在那个历史书上记载了，但是是在王的面前记下来的。
We can turn to chapter 2.
我们来看以斯帖记第二章。
We turn to chapter 2, verse 23.
我们来看以斯帖记二章二三节。
And when an inquiry was made into the matter, it was confirmed, and both were hanged on a gallows. And it was written in the book of the Chronicles in the presence of the king.
23节，纠察这事果然事实，就把二人挂在木头上，将这事在王面前写于历史上。
You know, for some reason, strange reason, the king did not reward him, you know, and then.
一个非常奇怪的事情就是当时呢，没有在那个时候呢，王立即去奖赏莫迪改。
Now, think about this, if someone, you know, have saved you before.
那我们来考想象一件事情，如果有一个人之前救过你，
obviously you feel grateful to the person. You want to, you know, repay the grace that he has shown to you.
那你肯定对这个人充满了感激，很想来报偿他。
You find that the repayment of grace is almost immediate. Yeah.
通常我们这样做呢，都是立刻就是这样去做的。
But for this incident here, the king delayed, you know, in rewarding Mordecai.
可是，在这个事件里面呢，不知道什么原因呢，王延迟了对莫迪改的奖赏。But
actually, this is the plan of God, you know, to expose Haman.
我们也能够 意识到呢，这是神的计划，是为了来揭示哈曼。
So on that night, when he was not able to sleep, when the chronicle, the history was read to him, he was very much touched.
那所以呢，当那个晚上他不能睡着的时候，他读到历史书，听到历史书上记载的这件事情的时候呢，他就非常的感动。
So and this, like in a way, has built up a very strong relationship between the king and Mordecai. At that critical moment,
因为这个事件呢，在那个关键的时刻呢，在王和莫迪改之间呢，就建立了一个非常紧密的关系。
So when you read up to it, you find that you know later on the king trusted so much in Mordecai.
所以呢，我们在读第八章的时候呢，我们就能看到，就是王之后呢，就非常的信任莫迪改。
Especially after Haman was hanged.
尤其是在哈曼被处死之后。
I want you to read chapter 8.
我们来读第八章。
We read chapter 8, verse 1.
第一节。
On that day, King Ahasuerus gave Queen Esther the house of Haman, the enemies of the Jews, and Mordecai came before the king. For Esther had told how he was related to her.
第一节，当日，亚哈随鲁王把犹大人仇敌哈曼的家产赐给王后以斯帖。莫迪改也来到王面前，因为以斯帖已经告诉王，莫迪改是他的亲属。
No one could easily come before the presence of the king.
没有人能够很容易的就来到王的面前。
We find that, you know, to be in the presence of the king actually was beneficial to the Jews later on.
那我们后来看到呢，因为后来呢，王就对犹大人呢非常的恩待。
You find that the second decree that issued by the king actually was written by Mordecai.
那我们也注意到第二个谕旨呢，就是颁给犹大人的那个谕旨呢，是莫迪改写的。
So you can see the arrangement of God in this history of salvation.
那我们就能够从中看到神在这个救赎的计划中的引导。
So God is in control of the situation.
因为神掌握了所有的一切。
We mentioned the other day when we were studying chapter 6.
那我们在学习查考第六章的时候，我们也提到
Esther was willing to risk her life.
以斯帖愿意去冒她的生命危险。
She was sacrificial, you know, she loved her nation.
她非常的爱她的民族。
Mordecai, you know, did not bow down to evil power, and he was very humble.
那莫迪改呢，不愿意向罪恶势力低头，他是一个非常谦卑的人。
After he has saved the king, yeah, though at the point in time he was not rewarded, he did not go around, you know, sounding his own trumpet, you know, what he has done for the king.
那尽管那个时候呢，他救了王，而王没有立刻的来奖赏他，他也没有到处去宣扬这件事情。
You find that God actually made use of this kind of people, yeah, to accomplish his task.
那神其实就是要用这样的人来完成他的计划。
We said, you know, we want to serve God.
我们说我们愿意服侍神。
But we must be ready to be used by God.
那我们也真的要准备好，愿意被神所用。
So you must show these spiritual qualities in our life.
那我们就要在我们的生命中彰显出这样特别的人性来，
美德
来。
It's not about you know how much we know about how intelligent we are or how educated we are.
不管我们有多聪明，或者说是受多大的、多少、多高的教育。
What God wants to see is, can we demonstrate His nature in our life?
神真正愿意见到的是我们如何在我们的日常生活中彰显出神的神性来。
Not only God made use of Esther, He also made use of someone, you know, who was unknown.
那这里呢，就是说一些，就是说。宁可为那些他不认识的人来。
Not only God made use of Esther, God also made use of someone unknown.
神不仅仅愿意来用以斯帖，也愿意用那些他不知道的人。
就是那个没有人知道的人。
没有人知道的人。
Mordecai, yeah.
比如默默无闻的人，比如说莫迪改。
Now we turn back to chapter 8.
我们来再翻到以斯帖记第八章。
We read verse 2.
我们来看第二节。
And now the Mordecai that was promoted.
莫迪改被奖赏了。
So the king took off his signet ring, which he had taken from Haman, and gave it to Mordecai and Esther, appointed Mordecai over the house of Haman.
那王摘下自己的戒指，就是从哈曼追回的，给了莫迪改。
The Bible does not, you know, clearly state that, like Haman was second to the king.
那这里圣经里面并没有特别的讲，就是哈曼是那个就是王以下的，只是仅次于王的那个人。
But judging from the book, it seems that you know Haman was very close to the king. It could be like this person. Who was second in command?
那从整个章节来看呢，我们能够看到哈曼是那个和王非常接近的，几乎是一人之上，万人之一人之下，万人之上。
We can read chapter 3.
我们来看第三节。
第三章。We read verse 1.
我们来看第一节。
Verse 1. Yeah.
第一节。
Verse 1, after these things, King Ahasuerus promoted Haman, the son of Hammedatha, the Agagites, and advanced him and set his seat above all the princes who were with him, above all the princes.
第一节里讲到他的位置呢是超过所有的同事的一切宰臣之上。
So very likely, you know, he was second in command in the country.
所以非常可能的呢，他就是在这个国家的当时王朝的第二把手。
You find that this position later was given to Mordecai.
那这个职位呢，后来就给了莫迪改。
Because the king's signet ring also was given to him.
因为王摘下自己的戒指，也给了莫迪改。
Now we turn back to chapter 8.
我们再回到第八。
I want to ask you a simple question.
我要问你们一个很简单的问题。
Think about this.
我们来看，想想这个。
How many times did Esther appear before the king?
那我们来想，以斯帖在王面前总共出现了几次。
So on my way here, I asked my family, and they gave me different answers.
我也问了我的家人，他们给了我不同的答案。
So my guess is two times.
我猜的是两次。
We read chapter 4.
我们来看第四章。
Verse 11.
第十一节。
And all the king's servants and the people of the king's provinces know that any man or woman who goes into the inner court to the king, who has not been called, he has by one law put all to death, except the one to whom the king holds out the golden scepter that he may live. Yet I myself have not been called to go into the king these 30 days. These are the words are spoken by Esther.
那这第四章十一节呢，就是以斯帖讲的话。
And those the first time that she went into the inner court of the king is in chapter 5, verse 2.
那她第一次去那个王的内院呢，是记载在第五章第二节。
So she risked her life, yeah, to see the king and telling the king that she wanted to invite him and Haman to come for the banquet.
那个时候呢，以斯帖冒着生命危险去邀请王和哈曼去参加他的宴席。
If I have read this correctly, the second time is the king came to Esther himself.
那如果我读的对的话呢，那第二次就是王自己来到以斯帖面前。
So in chapter 8.
所以在第八章的时候呢。
This is like the second time that, you know, verse 3, Esther went to see the king.
那这好像是以斯帖第三次去见王。
第一次去见王。
第二次。
我讲的不清楚。再来一次。Okay.This is the second time that Esther went to see the king.
那这是以斯帖第二次去见王。
Now, if you read verse 4,
如果我们来看第四节的话。
And the king held out the golden scepter towards Esther, so Esther arose and stood before the king.
第四节，王向以斯帖伸出金杖，以斯帖就起来站在王前。
Now, you find that every time when Esther, you know, saw the king,
我们看到就是每一次以斯帖看到王的时候呢
，and you know the response of the king was positive.
那每一次王呢都是非常正面的 一个反应。
Not only that, you know, the king even said, even up to half of my kingdom, I'm willing to give it to you.
甚至王每次都说呢，我愿意给把我的国的一半给你。
So again, you find that you know the king really was in good mood.
那也就是说呢，王当时呢的状态非常好。
I would say, you know, because God made him to be very, you know, happy.
因为我想讲的就是神让这个王呢非常高兴。
And so that, you know, when Esther went to see him, it's like, you know, he was more than willing to see Esther.
那所以当以斯帖去见王的时候呢，王是甚至于比以斯帖还愿意来见以斯帖。
So on this occasion, yeah,Esther made known the plot that Haman had earlier on with regards to how he wanted the entire nation of the Jewish people to be destroyed.
所以在这个状况下呢，以斯帖就向王提到了哈曼当时想如何来害整个犹大民族。
Now I want you to look at verse 7.
我们一起来看第七节。
The response from the king.
那来看王的反应。
The king, then King Ahasuerus said to Queen Esther, Mordecai is the Jew. Indeed, I have given Esther the house of Haman, and they have hanged him on the gallows because he tried to lay his hand on the Jews.
第七节，亚哈随鲁王对王后以斯帖和犹大人莫迪盖说，因哈曼要下手害犹大人，我已将他的家产赐给以斯帖，人也将哈曼挂在木架上。
Verse 8.
第八节，
you yourself write a decree concerning the Jews.
第八节说，现在你们可以，就是你自己来写这个谕旨。
That is Queen Esther and Mordecai could write a decree.
也就是说，这个王后以斯帖和莫迪改可以一起来写这个谕旨。
So they called the king's scribe to come in.
所以他们就把王的这个文书招来。
So it's like Mordecai dictated what to be written.
就好像是莫迪改来吩咐到底要写什么。
We can see this in verse 9.
我们可以来看第九节。
We read verse 9.
我们来读第九节。
So the king's scribes were called at the time in the third month, which is the month of Sivan, on the 23rd day, and it was written according to all that Mordecai commanded.To the Jews, the satraps, the governors, and the princes of the provinces from India to Ethiopia.
那第九节，三月就是西湾月二十三日，将王的书记召来，按着莫迪改所吩咐的，用各省的文字、各族的方言，并犹大人的文书方言写谕旨，传给那从印度直到古时127省的犹大人和总督省长首领。
Here we can see, you know, how the king trusted in Esther and Mordecai.
那这里我们可以看到王是多么的信任莫迪改和以斯帖。
And the signet ring was with Mordecai.
那现在这个印章的戒指呢，就是已经给了莫迪改。
So after he has written, you know, after he written the decree, and obviously he would just seal the letter himself.
所以呢，那个谕旨写了之后呢，他就自己就可以来用这个印章来盖。
So it's like you could see that the entire situation was turned around.
所以我们这个时候呢，就可以看到整个情况呢就翻转了。
So the Jews were given the right to defend themselves.
那这个时候呢，这些犹大人呢就被赋予了可以来抵抗这些要侵害他们性命的人。
They could also avenge themselves on their enemies.
他们可以来抵抗那些对抗他们的仇敌。
You find that this decree was given to all the provinces where the Jews were. Provinces.
这也就是说，这个谕旨呢被传到了所有的省份。
That's why you find that the Jews, in a way, were given a lifeline.
也就是这个时候呢，犹大人呢就可以来给了这个权利，能够来捍卫他们的性命。
So here we can see the miraculous work of God.
那我们在这里可以看到神奇的手笔。
So now we know that the first thing that we can learn from here is this.
我们第一个可以得到的教训是
You know, a decree was issued to annihilate the the Jewish nation.
那之前呢，这个圣谕谕旨呢是要去灭绝犹大人。
For some reason, you know, by the power of God, this decree was in a way nullified, if you like, or neutralized.
那可是我们可以看到因为某种原因呢，神让这个谕旨呢就是被中和了。
Because, you know, in like what we said before, in the time of the Persian Empire, no one could change the decree of the king.
因为我们之前也提到在波斯帝国的时候呢，那个时候没有任何人可以来改这个谕旨。
It was not possible for the Jews, any Jews, to survive.
那也就是说呢，任何情况下，这些犹大人都不可能会被存活。
Now what we say, because God was in control.
我们也知道神是掌控了一切的。
He has his way, you know, to help his own people.
他有他的方法来去帮助这些人。
So he neutralized, you know, the harmful effect created by Haman.
所以他综合了最后的这个会要灭绝犹大人的这个情况。
We said he also allowed the Queen Esther and Mordecai to nullify the first decree.
那他竟然也允许这个王后以斯帖和莫迪改呢去来综合第一个谕旨。
Put yourself in the shoes of a king.
我们站在王的地位上来想一想。
And to do that actually is to shame yourself.
因为如果是这样做的话呢，就是来羞辱他自己。
It means that this king was very, was not firm in his own decision.
好像会让人家以为这个王呢，对他自己的命令呢，不是那么坚定的。
We said this king was very fickle-minded. He could change anytime he wants.
会让人以为这个王呢，是他的意思呢是很随意。会改变的。
So to change in a way like to change the decree, you know, means that the king must lower himself.
那也就是说，如果要去改这个谕旨的话呢，神就王就要把他自己的位置放得很低。
But because God was in control.
但是因为神在这里掌控一切。
That's why you find that the king was willing to allow Queen Esther and Mordecai to do what they wanted to do.
因为神的控制呢。王就愿意莫迪改和以斯帖去改这个命令。
So what can we learn from here?
我们从中学到的教训是什么呢？
If you look at the history of the church,
如果我们来看教会的历史的话，
the church has gone through a period of struggle.
教会也经历各种各样的征战。
Sometimes you feel that, you know, the church is in a bad place, it's not in a good place.
那有的时候我们会觉得教会好像不是在一个很好的状况下。
We feel sad about the situation.
我们有的时候也为当时的处境而感到悲哀。
Many a time we do not know what to do.
很多时候我们也不知道到底要怎么做。
Actually, we should learn from Esther and Mordecai.
我们应该从以斯帖和莫迪改那里学到。
First, we must have a right relationship with God. That's the main thing.
首先我们要和神有一个非常好的关系。
If we want God to protect us and to protect the church,
如果我们希望神来保护我们，保护我们的教会的话，
we have to make sure that we are truly God's children.
我们必须确保自己真的是神的儿女。
If we don't even show any reverence to God,
如果我们不去向神表达我们和神的关系的话。
In our daily life, we live a very loose Christian life.
我们在我们的日常生活中很散漫的，不像一个基督徒那样散漫的生活。
How is God going to help us?
那这样的话，神如何才能会来帮助我们呢？
So we must live a godly life.
我们必须过着敬虔的生活。
Must demonstrate the virtues of God in our life.
应该在我们的生活中彰显神的美德。
And you'll find that God will make use of us to help the church.
那神就会来用我们来保护和帮助教会。
In a very miraculous fashion.
在一个非常奇妙的状况下。
So apart from praying to God,
除了向神祷告之外，
we have to make sure that our relationship with God is right.
那我们也要确保我们自己和神的关系是正确的。
The second point that we can learn from here,
我们学到的第二个教训是
We can see a contrast, a sharp contrast between Haman and Mordecai.
我们可以在这里看到非常明显的差别，也就是莫迪改和哈曼的差别。
We say Haman was a plotter or a conspirator.
我们说是哈曼是非常邪恶的，很阴险的。
He wanted to, you know, put people, the Jewish nation away.
他想把整个犹大民族毁灭掉。
Trying to frame, you know, Mordecai.
他想来
陷害
莫迪改。
So we said, you know, he was a wicked person.
他是一个很阴险的人。
But you find that God can remove, you know, such an individual.
我们也可以看到神可以把这样的人除灭。
So God eventually, you know, put him away by hanging him.
所以神就让他被处死，就让他从这里。
Now, when you look at Mordecai,
我们来看莫迪改的话,
he had a very humble beginning.
他开始的时候, 非常的谦卑,
someone who was unknown,
是一个默默无闻的人,
but God made use of him because he was faithful to God by not bowing down to Haman.
因为莫迪改对神的忠心, 他不愿意向,哈曼来下跪, 所以神就用他。
I think this is so important.
我们讲这是非常重要的。
Because he respected God more than man.
因为他敬神，更胜于人。
The problem with many of us, including myself, is that sometimes we respect man more than God.
那我们很多人的问题，包括我自己呢，就是我们有的时候呢，去敬人，更胜于敬神。
So when we respect man more than God, we find that our mind is clouded. We are not able to discern situation very clearly.
因为我们去更信人而不更敬神的话呢，我们的脑子呢好像是云雾满环绕，就是看不清状况。
You know, God has given us the word and the Holy Spirit.
神给了我们他的道理和给了我们圣灵。
So as long as we keep His word and pray in the Spirit all the time,
只要我们遵循在神的道理里。在圣灵里面祷告的话
You find that we will be given the power to respect God more than man.
那我们就会得到神给我们的力量，让我们敬神胜于人。
You know the problem with Eli.
我们看以利的那个问题。
以利
的问题。
You know, according to 1 Samuel.
再看撒母耳记上。
He respected his son more than God.
他更看重他自己的儿子而不是神。
In a family situation, you find that, you know, the father respected the son more than God.
那在很多家庭里面呢，有的时候我们对待一个父亲对待儿子呢，有的时候会更胜于神。
This is wrong.
这是错的。
Because, you know, our respect for our children or our respect for our father must be based upon our respect for God.
那我们在一个家庭里面，无论是父与子或者子与父呢，这样的关系呢，都是首先要在敬神的前提下面来产生的。
So you find that Mordecai was an exceptional individual.
那所以我们可以在这里看到呢，莫迪改是一个非常不一般的人。
And he did not go around sounding his own trumpet, you know, having done great things for the king.
而且呢，他不会到处去宣扬他为王所做的这些事情。
That's why he was chosen by God.
所以他就是神所拣选的。
So this is something that we can learn from here.
这就是我们可以从中学到的一些。
Now, the one more teaching is about Esther.
另外一个教训呢是有关以斯帖的。
Again, she was a very humble woman.
她也是一个非常谦卑的女。
So she risked her life at least 2 times, yeah, to go to see the king.
所以她愿意两次冒着生命危险去见王。
So you can see the how pure her sacrifice was for the people.
所以能从中看到她为她的百姓所做的非常纯粹的牺牲。
Sometimes our sacrifice may not be pure.
那有的时候我们的牺牲呢并不是很单纯的。
Our sacrifice is intended with our own interest in mind.
那我们的牺牲有的时候是因为想得到我们自己想要的。
But for Esther, you find that, you know, she risked her life without any benefits.
可是这里呢，以斯帖愿意毫无 回报的去来牺牲他的生命。
That's why, you know, she was blessed by God.
所以这也就是为什么神会祝福他。
And it's also that she has been prepared for this purpose.
那而且他也是为了这个目的呢，是被预备的。
That's why she became the queen.
所以她被选为皇后。
To save God's people.
是为了去救神的百姓。
Finally,
最后
I want to read chapter 8 verse 17.
那我们来一起来看第八章的十七节。
Chapter 8 verse 17.
第八章十七节。
And in every province and city, wherever the king's commands and decree came, the Jews had joy and gladness, a feast and a holiday. Then many of the people of the land became Jews because fear of the Jews fell upon them.
第十七节，王的谕旨所到的各省各城，犹大人都欢喜快乐，设摆宴席，以那日为吉日。那国的人民有许多因惧怕犹大人，就入了犹大籍。
You know, the Jewish nation at that time was at the point of being completely wiped out.
因为那个时候呢 犹大族呢差一点就被整族灭绝了。
When you look at the conclusion to chapter 8,
如果我们来看第八节的最后的总结的话
is the rendering here is correct, the translation here is correct. The people of the land, mean non-Jewish people, became Jews.
那这里如果翻得对的话呢就是那国的人民不仅是犹大人很多人也愿意来入这个犹大籍。
Meaning that they wanted to be with the Jews.
也就是说他们愿意和犹大人在一起。
Because the fear of the Jews fell upon them.
因为那个时候他们很怕犹大人。
It's like the power of God was with the Jews.
也就是说神的大能呢和犹大人在一起。
We say, how can we overcome the world?
那我们讲我们如何才能攻克这个城呢这个世界呢
First, we must allow the power of God to shone in the community of faith, the church.
那我们首先要让神的能呢是在我们这个信仰的团体里面就是教会里面彰显。
How could that be done?
那这样怎么才能做到呢?
When each and every one of us becomes godly, then you find that the power of God would manifest in the church.
那首先我们每个人都要让自己变得敬虔之后呢神的大能就会在我们这里彰显。
If we are humble, if we are pure before God, you know, if we are sacrificial, then we see that the power of God will be shown.
如果我们敬虔我们谦卑我们愿意为神牺牲的话呢我们所有的这些人呢都能看到神的大能在我们之中彰显。
We need to bear this in mind.
我们必须牢记这些。
Serving God is not about, you know, how much you have done.
为神服侍不是说你做了多少。
So when we serve the Lord,
当我们来服侍神的时候呢
we have to ensure that all the works that we have done is built upon the foundations of having the virtues of God in our life.
那我们要记得无论我们做什么呢我们都要记得神
我们所服侍的基础。
我们所服侍的基础就是
拥有神的美德在我们生命中。
拥有神的美德在我们的生命中。
And in this one, you find that the power of God will be shown.
只有这样的话呢，我们就能够看到神的大能在我们中间彰显。
God is more than willing to work with us.
神也更愿意呢来帮助我们。
God is more than willing to use us to accomplish His will.
神也更愿意来用我们呢来完成他的大计。
So may God help all of us.
愿神帮助我们所有的人。
And we hope that we can learn from the good examples of. Esther and Mordecai.
我们也希望我们能从以斯帖和莫迪改这里学到很多。
Let's pray together.
让我们一起祷告。